Can we just throw it up to the top?
Yeah.
No, I'll explain the whole cycles.
Alright, I am recording, so whenever you guys are ready to go.
Come on, put it up to the top. Other way. You're close. There you go. So what we created was Tripzilla. Tripzilla is gonna be an app that, you know, when you go to like Expedia or Kayak, you're only able to get like the flights, you know, cheapest flights, but you're not able to get, you know, like points of interest, like if there's any museums around or restaurants. So what we did with Tripzilla is every time that you search a flight, you're gonna get another page with your points of interest, you know, anywhere from restaurants, shops, museum, and, you know, locally accessible areas for you to go to, so that you have a rounded trip once you get there. Albert did most of the HTML and CSS.
So what I did, I used a lot of HTML CSS, but I used the Materialize library. That one was pretty new, so it was kind of hard to really deal with in general. Like in terms of documentation, it's hard to like find things. And like the way they explain it was like very vague. Also the layout, like especially the form, was like, we looked at a lot of other, I guess, travel sites and just saw what the basic, what everyone else had, because I think that was like the basic information everyone needs in order to like search for certain things, like in terms of locations. So in terms of challenges, it was a lot of the documentation for the Materialize like library. Like I also found that some things, and when I try to tailor it in our own style sheet, like the Materialize CSS style sheet would also be like very resistant to what I'm trying to do. So that one was like, especially for certain form elements, like this font was real, like it was unchangeable in a way. So I just want to keep looking at that, because I couldn't like change it even if I, me and Brian like did everything we could.
It's making me angry just thinking
about it. So things I wanted to add in the future was maybe like design a little fun like logo for it, just like near the top. Make, I guess, a less cheesy, cliche, I guess, motto. Because it's live, love, and travel right now. And, you know, I guess there's a ring to it. Also, I wanted to have, like, a little fun, like when it's, like, loading a search, like, this cursor would turn into, like, a globe with, like, a plane around it or something like that. But, you know. Another thing I wanted to change a little bit in the future was just like on the next page when you do search something, we had the results come out in like a table form, but the table form is very plain, so we just wanted to like improve on that into like its own like pretty containers or something like that.
So,
Mike,
you want to go ahead and you want to put in like EWR and where we're flying from and to, and then we'll generate ourselves.
Can you explain the function?
Yeah, we're going to generate. So on the site, when you go in, you're gonna put your 3-digit code. Something that we want to add is like a drop down. So when you do like, right now it's just domestic, it's not international, because we had a hard code all of the 3-digit codes.
Yeah, because all the APIs that we got, they are taking only the IATA code. So, and it's very difficult because we didn't get the API to convert the cities, the airport names to IATA codes. So we had to right now hard code it. But yeah, that's the future goal. Like we have to put something, some API to get the IATA code from the cities or the airport names.
So right now it's just a domestic website. You go ahead, you're gonna click on people you want, no children, and that's gonna pop up to no children flying. It's gonna give you your first 10 solutions, your date origin, your departure time, and these are all real time. It's not, you know, from yesterday. It's actual times that you can go in and select.
So it's giving from the lowest to the rates as such, like from the lowest. Top 10, because we selected the 10 most solutions as of now. So the API that we used here is the QPX Express API, that is from the Google API itself. They are giving that API. So the parameters that they are taking is the origin, destination, the number of solutions, and the date right now, and number of tickets. So as she said, the challenge right here is that we don't have IATA code, API for the IATA code converting from the city names itself. So right now we are hard coding the IATA code, that is for each and every airport there are 3-digit letters. So we are using that. In future we like to add that API. Yeah. And Yeah, the second API that we used is the Google Maps API that Gianna did.
Points of interest.
Yeah.
So with the API code for Google Maps, which Google Maps, I can tell everybody had a problem with Google Maps. I think we spent like 2 days trying to figure that out. Was that, you know, their latitude and longitude is obviously not correct. They're giving like a 4-digit number at the end of the dot, but it's really like a 9. So with that API, they're able to give you within like a radius. We have like a 500-mile radius from the airport, which is probably like, you know, the whole state. But anywhere from the airport or where you're going to be, it's going to list out everything. You know, Hudson Bookstore, Starbucks, places that you can go. And eventually what I want to do is like for the restaurants, there'll be like a link to OpenTable so that if you do want to book your flight for OpenTable, you can go in and you can have your restaurant, you know, do your reservation. Starbucks doesn't have reservations there.
Yeah, that's because this API takes types that she has given right now stores. So other than that, it can take the hospitals nearby, the police stations, church, anything. Basically,
table,
when you go to a new place, you want something. So the traveler will, you know, have on the go wherein he can search for a particular specific thing.
So some other things that in the future that I wanted to add, like I really liked your website. You guys, like the cheapest place at the restaurant, like that could be something that eventually, like, we try and use your website, but we can throw it to your, throw it to your website. You know, you find the cheapest place to eat. Since some people might be doing this, you know, on a budget because it is trying to find the cheapest airlines. In the future, what I also want to do is create another page. So, you know, like when you're going shopping, you know, you click everything, you grab it, you throw it into your cart, and you check out. What I want to do is it's going to be like the application you see on your phone. You have all your flights. And it's only going to give you the apps that are able to eat, like, able to create like $800. Like, say you're going to Sedona for 4 nights. You know, within your hotels and your trip, you're only going to get the parameters that equal 800. So it doesn't matter what hotel or what flight you put into your cart, at the end of it, it's going to be less than 800 or equal to. And then you can book all your restaurants. So when you check out, that's the budget that you were given, and then you're able to travel with that. I think some of the challenges we faced was that API was just, I can't get over that API. It was just so many errors, and then that hard coding for a little 3 digits, the airlines, mm-hmm. It's a lot. And even though we had that many airports in the United States, it was insane. Because it brought up like private airports, like internet, like, you know.
Yeah.
Or you can just fly out of, you know, with your private
like Teterboro
jet, like,
and all them. Yeah.
Yeah, even the autocomplete that we wanted to use, that was giving just the city names, but it was not taking the IATA code.
Oh, okay.
So for the particular airport name.
Also going to try Foundation, Richard. Vouch for it, so you know.
And then just like booking.com, where you can go in, you can like make your own profile. I want to be able to go in to make our own profile so that when you constantly come back, so it can be like a point system, and then you can link and have like your own preferences. And every time like when you pop up, it'll be all the restaurants that you want to go to, the hotels you stayed at. So it's gonna be like a really interactive website.
Cool. Good job, guys. This is really awesome. Good job on the career. It's not easy. It's not easy to use. It's not even in version 1 yet.
And we even found like the bug, remember?
Yeah, yeah. It's so like you use something that's like not even like, you should tell them that you're a beta tester. Maybe they'll give you stuff. So does anybody have any questions? You guys kind of like answer all the questions I would have about like like moving on, like what you want to build into it. You guys should just team up. You guys should just merge. You guys should just like merge.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think what's hard, just pulling a lot. It was just pulling so much data. Like at the airport.
Don't even check.
Like every airport.
You guys can all like effectively team up in here. You can like book a trip. You can book some place to go sell your stuff somewhere else. You guys can figure out where to drink in other places.
Where to go eat after.
Yeah, where to go eat
before you go to the airport.
Yeah.
Do it on the way.
Or what kind of beer you can have at the airport.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The strongest is my normal choice.
A lot of airports are like putting